let me live then. I still live that life. Professor Venkat Rao, Professor Zubba Rao, Professor Akash Sharma, Professor Siddharth Sharma, Siddharth Mishra Ji, our Dean, Charulata Ji, Shilpa Katri Baba, Saroni Priya, Professor Vich, and of course, I mean, the person who, Kanta Malik, I can name almost everybody in the faculty. And I must thank Vineet. He has been taking very keen interest since last 2-3 days. And he's very simple, very quiet, very humble, mild-mannered. But he took keen interest because he wanted to live the precepts that Swamiji preached. It's difficult to get such moments when you enliven Swamiji, his life, his ideals, and all that he stood for. It was under a silver oak tree on a full moon night at Mayavati. It's a place called Advaita Ashram. I forgot Rashmiji. Thank you. You are a very accomplished singer and you sang so well. I could understand the meaning, though it was in Marathi. So it was under a silver oak tree on a full moon night that I and Swami Jitatmanji, who was the editor of Prabuddha Bharat, the first journal that Swami Vivekananda started, The Awakened India. At that time, awakening of India could not perhaps be perceived or thought of. But then Swamiji had foreseen that India is going to be a superpower. India is not going to be just simple India, a small colony of the British. But India is going to be a mighty power, a superpower. What he preached was that we need to awaken Indians from their deep slumber. And that was his life's mission, which he accomplished during his lifetime. Well, for me, it's very emotional because on that night when we were sitting in under a silver oak tree on a full moon night at Advaita Ashram, Mayavati. Advaita Ashram is, there was one Captain Xavier. He was in the British Army, but was deeply inspired and impressed with Swamiji's eloquence and his brilliance. So he placed to raised a temple in his memory in the Himalayas. And he perhaps thought that there's more of idol worship in India. And then Swamiji told him, I don't want any picture and I don't want any idol. I want this place for man to contemplate and to know his true nature. He himself is the Brahma, is the ultimate truth. Here people should come and contemplate and have self-realization. I don't want any idol, I don't want any pictures around. Some books can be kept if someone wants to read, some scriptures, 100 years old, 500 years old, a couple of thousand years old also, and nothing else. At the altar in the evening, the monks gather to get after the dinner, And then one monk will raise one question pertaining to life and its existence. Nothing about physics, but all about metaphysics. What is beyond this physical self? Is there something which is beyond that? And on that night, he ignited a spark in me. So he said, "Well, Dr. Watts, we have been here together for long, and it's very rare opportunity when the president of the ashram permits the devotees from Delhi." I was at the time on the managing committee of Ramakrishna Mission Delhi. So I've had that privilege of going to Advaita ashram in Mayavati. And an idea flashed his mind. He said, "There isn't an education institution worthy of being named after Swami Vivekananda." And then I resolved to sell my ancestral home. I said, "Let this honest money earned through hard-earned money of my father, let me sow this seed." I could never imagine that this will grow as big as that it is now. It has to grow further. It is going to be a seamless growth as I foresee it. Because what Swamiji said is going to last about 500 years. That's what prophecy was made by Nodadinda's guru, Thakur Ramakrishna Paramhans. Whatever you say, Narendra, is going to last for 500 years, is going to inspire the coming generation for 500 years, and is going to impact the society, Indian society, in a big way. He was Lord Shiva, you know, Bhakt. In the beginning, he followed that path of bhakti. In the morning, he used to meditate upon Lord Shiva in a Shiva temple. And as the story goes, that some black cobra appeared and it was about to bite, and the mother came and she wanted to rescue, but he was in deep trance, and from the deep trance he was unperturbed. He was not even aware of that there's a dangerous cobra, poisonous cobra. The mother watched in silence. She was helpless. And Swamiji's awakening took place. From there, some inspiration came and he went to look for a guru, some guide, some spiritual guide. And he had heard of Thakur Ramakrishna Paramhans, who often used to go in Bhava Samadhi. Bhava Samadhi is when you are thinking about the God, about the Lord, about the ultimate truth, you go into a state of ecstasy. So he went to him and he put him a very straight question: "Have you ever seen God?" And when Thakur Ramakrishna Paramhans was confronted with this question of, "If you have seen God," then Thakur Ramakrishna Paramhans shot back, "I can see God as I can see you now. Can I also see that?" "Yes, you can also see that." And through very arduous spiritual practices, Swamiji realized his true nature, that he was not the flesh and bones, but he was the soul, the eternal soul, boundless, infinite energy in him. And then he decided to go to the West and tell what Hinduism stands for. And that's why he is termed as Hindu monk. Roman Roland wrote about Swamiji. How many of you have read that? I'll read it out to you. Swamiji's words were a great music. Phrases in the style of Beethoven. Swamiji's words were great music and phrases in the style of Beethoven, stirring rhythms like the march of Handel choruses. I cannot touch these sayings of his. Scattered as they are through the pages of books, at 30 years distance, without receiving a thrill through my body like an electric shock. Roman Roland said, Swamiji's words are great music, phrases in the style of Beethoven, stirring rhythm like march of Handel choruses. I cannot touch these sayings of his, scattered as they are through the pages of books at a 30 years distance without receiving a thrill through my body like an electric shock. That's what Roman Roland said. And it's true. Even today I can feel a lot of energy in me when I speak about Swamiji. All those who know this prayer, may sing. All those who don't want to join me may not sing. Namami Samishan Nirvana Rupam. Namami Samishan Nirvana Rupam. Vibhum Vyapakam Brahma Veda Sarupam. Nijam nirgunam nirvikalpam niriham chidakash makash vasam bhajeham nirakar onkar moolam turiyam giragyan goti tagisham gitam girisham karalam mahakal kalam kripalam gunagar sansar param natoham tushara drisankash gauram gambhiram manobhuti koti prabhashri shariram Safrun namoli kallolini charu ganga lasad bhala balendu kanthe bhujanga. I say it again, I repeat it, because somewhere 2.5 hours now, Professor Venkatrao conveys to me, you are being very treacherous. You promised for 2 hours and you are far exceeding that. Anyway, he was the Shiva Bhakt, and today Rudra Avatar, Hanuman Ji's day. Hanuman Chalisa to sab log padh lete honge. Hanuman Chalisa kar sakte hain sab log mil ke kar sakte hain. Jai Hanuman Gyan Gun Sagar, Jai Kapish Tihu Loku Jagar, Rama Duta Tulit Bal Dhama, Anjani Putra Pon Sut Nama, Mahavir Vikram Bajrangi, Kumati Nivar Sumati Ke Sangi, Kanchan Varan Virashvesha, Kanan Kundal Kunchit Kesha, Hathvajr Dhujavirajain, Kandhe Mujjane Usajain, Shankar Swan Kesri Nandan, Shankar Swan Kesri Nandan, Tej Pratap Mahajagvandan, Vidyavan Guniti Chatur, Ramakash Garbheko Atur, Prabhu Charitra Sunveko Rasya, Ramlakan Sitaman Vasya, Sukshan Rupdai Sihi Dikhava, Vikar Rupdai Lankitarava, Bhim Rupdai Sarsuhare, Ramchandra Ke Kaas Samare, Lai Sanjeevan Lakshman Jivai, Shripati Harshiur Lai, Rakpati Kini Bhat Badai, Tumam Priya Bhat Sambhai, Saisvadan Tumurujas Gami, Asken Shripati Kantala Gami, Sanakadik Brahmadik Munisha, Narad Sarad Sahita Isha, Yamko Bhirdik Pai Jahate, Kavi Kovit Kaisa Kekahate, तुम उपकार सुग्रीव कीना, राम मेरा राजपति ना, तुम्हारा मंत्र विक्षण माना, लंकेश्वर भाई सब्यक जाना, युग सहस योजन पर भानु, लीनो ताही मधुर फल जानू, प्रभु मुद्रिका मेले मुख माही, जल्दी लांगे गए चर नाही, दुर्गम काम जगत के जेते, सुगम अनुग्रह तुम रहते थे, राम दुरारे तुम रखवारे, होतना गया बिन पे सारे, सब सुख रहे तुम्हारी शरणा, तुम रक्ष का हो को डरना, आपन थे समारोह आप, तीनों लोग हाँकते काप, भूत पिशाच निकट नहीं आवें, महावीर जब नाम सुनावें, नासे रोग हर सब पीरा, जपत निरंतर हनुमंत पीरा, संकट ते हनुमान छुड़ावें, मन करम वचन ध्यान जुलावें, सब पर राम तपस्वी राजा, तिनके काज सकल तुम साजा, और मन और अर्थ जो को इलावें, तासु मित जीवन फल पावें, चारों युग प्रताप तुम्हारा, है प्रसिद्ध जगत उजारा, साधु संत के तम रखवारे, असुर निकंदन राम दुलारे, अर्ष सिद्धि नवनिधि के दाता, अश्वर दीन जानकी माता, राम रसायन तुमरे पासा, सदा रहो रघुपति के दासा, तुमरे भजन राम को पावें, जन्म जन्म के दुख में अंतकार पति पुर जाई, जहाँ जन्म रे भक्त कहाई, और देवता चित्तन धाई, हनुमन से सब सुख करें, संकट कटे मिटे सा पीरा, जो सुमरे हनुमन बल वीरा, जय 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 हनुमान गोसाई, कृपा करो गुरुदेव के नाई, हे शत बार पाठ कर जोई, छुट्टी बंदी महासुख होई, जो ये पढ़े हनुमान चालीसा, हो सिद्ध साखी गौरीशा, तुलसीदास सदा हरि चेरा, कीजिए नाथ हृदय मुंडेरा, पवन तने संकट हरण, मंगल मूर्ति रूप, राम लखन सीता सहित, हृदय बसों सुरूप, श्यापति रामचंद्र की जय, पंसुत हनुमान की जय। भगवान हनुमान जी जो हैं वो रुद्र अवतार हैं, भगवान शिव के अवतार हैं, और आज उनका दिन है, मंगलवार है, इस वजह से हमने कहा कि आज हनुमान चालीसा कर लिया जाए। वैसे तो मेरा जो आराध्य देव हैं, आराध्य माँ हैं, मैं माँ भगवती की पूजा करता हूँ और साथ साथ भगवान शिव की भी करता हूँ, लेकिन भगवान शिव और मंगलवार को, सोमवार को भगवान शिव की करता हूँ, लेकिन मेरा जो इष्ट देव है माँ है, भगवती हैं। सोमवार में हम कहाँ हैं, कभी भगवती के स्तोत्र सुनाएंगे उनको, पूरा स्तोत्र सुनाएंगे बहुत टाइम लगेगा, पौना घंटा लग जाएगा, इसलिए उसको आज नहीं करेंगे, लेकिन हम लोग अंदर कुछ अपने अंदर कुछ चैतन्यात्मक शक्ति को पैदा करें। सिद्धार्थ मिश्रा जी कह रहे थे, गुरु गोविंद सिंह जी से बहुत प्रभावित थे स्वामी विवेकानंद जी, और स्वयं और गुरु गोविंद सिंह जी भी स्वयं स्वामी जी से बहुत प्रभावित थे। ये जो समधर्मा लोग होते हैं, समान धर्म के जो लोग होते हैं, उनमें कोई ना कोई चीज़ कॉमन होती है, वो निर्भय होते हैं, निर्भीक होते हैं, क्योंकि उनको मरने का डर नहीं रहता है। तो आज हम स्वामी विवेकानंद जी की जयंती मना रहे हैं, उनका बर्थडे मना रहे हैं, 158 बर्थडे स्वामी विवेकानंद वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग, एंड आई थिंक दिस इज द बेफिटिंग ट्रिब्यूट दैट ईच वन ऑफ यू, चारू मैम कुडंट गेट ए अपॉर्चुनिटी, हरदीप गॉट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी, शोमा मैम शी ऑल्सो गॉट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी, संत he came on his piano, and this piano he bought from his own salary, so he raised the money then bought the piano, so he too has rendered a beautiful song. I couldn't really make out much of it, but then I thank each one of you for having to spare so much of your valuable time, and our boys and girls who have performed so extremely well, and your each performance was superb, immaculate and spellbound. I really thank each one of my children who have sang so beautifully the Ramakrishna Mission Aarti, which is sung in the evening and in the morning hours at the Ramakrishna Mission. And each one of you have perfected that. I must thank Saloni for she is being the dean of the students, you know, welfare activities. So with these words, I thank each one of you and express my deep sense of gratitude for having to spare this valuable time. But I think it's worth, because today Swamiji showers his blessings in bounty. And each one of you deservedly will march forward, and I'm sure there's going to be no limits. Earlier we used to say sky is the limit, but now sky is not the limit. You are going to go beyond the sky. Anyone who is associated with this mission, or this institution, which is perfectly, the dean said, it looks like a temple. Let's make it worthy of a temple where people bow in obeisance and can feel that vibe that Swamiji lives here and he's there to help us because he never liked weakness. And as one of the speakers said, I want you to be masters and not like slaves. I don't want you to act like slaves. Behave like masters. And you behave like masters when you have perfected a particular knowledge. So he's a constitutional expert, so Professor Subbarao. And he speaks authoritatively and so assertively. It's so beautiful listening to him. So I thank each one of you from the core of my heart, and particularly for the forbearance that you all had, that you come on. And my sincerest apologies to Professor Venkatrao because he's punctual and he was not here at 12 o'clock. So thank you very much. And each one of you will have prasad because that's coming straight from Swamiji. So each one of you should go with prasad. And anyone who doesn't get it can come to me and I'll immediately procure it. Thank you so much. Thank you.